Up, down, left, right, B, A, start. That is the level select cheat, and that's how we're going to begin this video. Hey everyone, welcome, this is Ferret, and this is the 7th part of my Let's Play of Sonic the Hedgehog, but before I do the final zone and beat the game, I'm going to do all the special stages and compile them into one video. As you can see, that's the level select cheat, which will let you actually start one of them right away. And I just wanted to put these all together, because they're kind of fun. It's fast-paced, it's got some nice colorful graphics. Basically, the goal is you're playing as Sonic the Hedgehog, and you're spinning around, but you can jump and move to a degree, and the stage is constantly moving. You need to get the Chaos Emeralds, which are hidden in each of these levels. And many people don't actually know this, but there's actually many different blocks in the special stages that have a bunch of features. There's the normal blocks, which are the rectangular objects that are blue and green. Nothing special, you can jump off of them and they're just there. There's the goal blocks, which, despite their very deceptive name, will not get you the Chaos Emerald. They will end the bonus stage early. And that's kind of annoying, because you only have 10 chances to get Chaos Emeralds in this game, assuming you do 50 reigns for all the stages except for the last world. There's diamond-shaped blocks, which are the ones you break open to get the Chaos Emerald. There's bumpers, which are kind of like springs of sorts, if you know what I mean. Jump stands, which are these circular things that I was on. The, like, pinwheel-like objects. Which, they actually affect Sonic's ability to move around, and they change direction, I think, based on how often you hit the up and down panels. And speaking of which, if you hit the up and down blocks, it changes the speed at which the stage rotates, which is something I actually didn't know before doing research for this, so that's kind of neat. And then, of course, there's reverse, which changes the direction of the movement. Anyways, back to the game. One thing I don't get, I don't understand why there's a bunch of birds in the background. They're trying to go for like a pseudo-surreal type of effect here, but there's like birds in every one of these levels, which is kind of strange, but hey, whatever. It's a video game, whatever works. It certainly looks impressive from a graphical standpoint. And they change the fish when they go in the other direction. Maybe that's to help distinguish direction? I don't know. It's just strange. But here we go, about to get yet another Chaos Emerald. Yay, shiny objects! Also in this game, there's a debug mode you can go into, which lets you place objects around the stage. Like rings, enemies, and all sorts of other stuff. You can actually glitch the game into getting 7 emeralds, or excuse me, 6 emeralds, 7's not until Sonic 2, right from the start, if you like get certain special stage objects onto the main stage, which is kinda neat. The debug code, which I'll post in this video, is up C, down C, left C, right C, A plus start. That's a pretty cool trick I might show you guys later. It lets you just mess around with the boundaries and the coding. It's kind of like a, you can think of it like a testing interface, which is kind of neat. Again, as mentioned, there's only 6 Chaos Emeralds in the first Sonic the Hedgehog game. There's more in Sonic 2 and Sonic 3, where you start to have 7. And the special stages are kind of cool in that as well. In Sonic 2, you get a half-pipe-like structure, which creates like a, not necessarily mode 7, but a similar kind of a 3D effect. You have to move along the half-pipe at fast speeds, with Tails to collect your rings and avoid bombs and get a certain amount before you reach a goal, which is fun. Sonic 3 and Sonic & Knuckles, which are both part of the same game pretty much, have an orb type of level, which is kind of interesting. Requires a lot of reaction, as opposed to strictly speed. And it gets faster as you go on. There were also, apparently, supposed to be, in the beta version of this game, you were supposed to access the special stages for this game via standing on certain blocks, because there were sprites left over, like one for each world and how to access the levels. This would have been similar to the Sega Master System games, or at least some of them in the Game Gear games, where you have to step on certain, like, items and blocks to access the stages. In the first Sonic the Hedgehog game on the Master System, you just looked for emeralds that were hidden in the level. There weren't any bonus stages, which is kind of disappointing, but still, that was the first one. And it came around the same time as the Sega Genesis version, I believe. So, kind of neat and all. We're almost done. And that was the last emerald. I'll see you guys in the last video where we'll fight the final boss and get the good ending of the game. Thanks again for watching. I'll see you all later.